Hi everyone, it's Danny, your scrapper on the street here. It's day 21 of October Load. I cannot believe we are on day 21 already. And I am sad because there's no true scrap today, so I didn't have that to wake up and look forward to, and I haven't been sitting in class all day, but I have been thinking a lot about what I learned, and I am going to rewatch a lot of those classes many, many times, so hopefully y'all will join us next time if you didn't this time around. And for those of you who did join us, thank you for just making it such a spectacular experience. This was my fourth one, but by far my favorite, and I think because I was able to dedicate all the days to it, that I just really got the most out of it. So thank you for that, especially Lane and Miss Kelly, who are just outstanding human beings, just all around, forget scrapbookers and friends. They're just amazing people overall. So that being said, today we had to fight evil and see what I can't even describe today's prompt as well as it was in the email this morning without being verbatim, but what have we overcome? And my mom will tell you, I have tried for many, many, many years to find a craft or a hobby that I was good at. I've always written, I've always taken pictures, always. But as far as hobbies, I've tried to cross stitch, and I just don't have the patience for that, though I do pull it out from time to time. My mom has tried to teach me how to crochet. That was a disaster. My mom used to teach ceramics classes, and I was always the worst one in the class. Like, how embarrassing for my poor mom. I can never find anything that would really click, and the biggest thing was because of my patience. I just don't have them. And for scrapbooking, I don't know if it's so much I have the patience for it, but so much of it doesn't have to be as tedious. I could fit it to how I want to do it, I guess. So today I did my layout on scrapbooking, and just, I knew I wanted to add a lot of writing. So I had this simple stories paper, and I just, using so much of what I learned in class with inking and layering and stacking and journaling, I just to put everything into use today. And I focused on where this hobby has taken me. It started as something I did just to have a place for my photos and to just document life and trips and birthdays. That's how I started off, thinking, oh, I will pass these down to our children and they could see our life. And then as it changed, because we struggle with having children, it's not something that's going to happen. And so it was like, well, why do I do it still if I don't have that to pass on to, that legacy? And I do it because I still love it. I still love to do it. I still take pictures. I still write every day. So why not do it? And then the journaling just goes on and on. It's very lengthy. And I use Tim Holtz distress markers. It's my new favorite journaling pen marker. I have a bunch of them right here. So I use the black one. I just go on to say how it changed from to document to pass down to just document to document. And to, it's a creative outlet, both for the writing and the photo taking and the supplies. And then it transformed into something I do that I could share with others, whether it be, and this picture was taken yesterday. Mike took it while I was intensely focused on one of the classes. I don't even remember which one. It was later in the day, I could tell you that, but otherwise I don't know. But I was intensely focused on whichever class was going on. And this picture really shows that, you know, I have notebooks and my Kindle and a pen and my coffee and my phone and my computer, and I'm just focused on writing and capturing and documenting everything. So that's how scrapbooking has changed. It started out as one thing, as something just like, oh, well, yeah, okay, I'll scrapbook, I take pictures, into this huge thing that's just, it's not just a hobby anymore. It's a lifestyle. I take pictures every day. I think, what can I do with this? I'm constantly learning, whether it's in True Scrap or Lane's Scrapinars every month, or just from talking to the girls on Scrap Happy, or just talking to girls in general, or my mom takes classes that I don't take, and we exchange ideas, or I flip through magazines. But I'm constantly learning and working, and it's become my life, scrapbooking. So I know it sounds super cheesy to say that, like, oh, scrapbooking's my life, but it really is what it's become, just an outlet. And I'm going to take that and transform it, and I'm going to put together some cool art journals. Thanks to the classes yesterday, you guys rock, but it's going to transform again into something bigger and more. And so that is what I captured in today's layout, and I did not mean to ramble on for 6 minutes, so I apologize, and thank you for bearing with me, and I will see you tomorrow for hopefully a much shorter video. Have a great day, everybody. Bye.